weather with blueinsurance.ie. Saying no to home insurance with your bank, saying yes to big savings only at blueinsurance.ie. That's the latest on Classic Hits 4FM.
Mission 21.
With the Down Syndrome Centre. Help us raise €21,000 in just 5 days on Classic Hits 4FM.
Well done, well done, well done to everybody who's been donating over the last 4 or 5 days. It's not a boiler but until 3 o'clock, and this is, pardon me, the last day of Mission 21. Now, thanks to everybody, we got to our target of 21,000 just before 3 o'clock yesterday, and I thank particularly all my own listeners as well. Gareth O'Callaghan pushed it even further. We got it out to 23 or 24, and I'm going to give you an update in about 5 minutes' time. We're hoping, maybe we could get to 30 grand at this rate. I'll find out exactly how much Damien raised in the last couple of hours, and I know Damien was down the Down Syndrome Centre today. But remember, if you want to donate, you can. You can still do it. We're finishing it up today, and I know how appreciative they are at the Down Syndrome Centre. All those kids who have those special challenges in life, and all the parents who have those very difficult challenges as well, raising their children. And they need support, they need help, they need your help. All you got to do is text DSC to 50300. That's DSC to 50300. Remember, of course, 100% of your donation goes to the Down Syndrome Centre across most network operators. Now, some do charge VAT, but as I said before, there's not a lot we can do about that. But you won't get charged the VAT. It just means they get a little bit less, 325. So do it now if you haven't done it already all week. This is our last push today. You won't have to hear me babbling on about it after today, all right? But I can tell you, they are so happy in the Down Syndrome Centre today. So happy that we've exceeded our expectations. In the 5 days, we've gone past the 21,000. We could hit 30. That would be just absolutely amazing, wouldn't it? To stand there with a cheque for €30,000 to hand over for facilities for those children. If you want to go to classickids.ie, you can. You can donate as much as you want there. Just click the donate button, all right? So remember, text DSC to 50300. And remember, it's a €4 text, okay? A text is €4. Now, we've a lot to get through today, including, by the way, what's the worst ever gift you've given on Mother's Day? Well, a new survey out suggests a frying pan, an iron, and a carton of milk ranked among the worst Mother's Day gifts ever received. I'm going to be asking you later on what you're going to buy your missus for Mother's Day. Also, don't forget, for all the texts we got in today, we got a great prize. We got an overnight stay for two people in the beautiful Salt Hill Hotel in Galway, overlooking the promenade. It's a beautiful hotel, and we're going to give that away today. We've already got four people in the draw. We'll pick one random person out of the texts we get in today, all the texts we get in today, so just keep texting and get involved in the show. All right, and they will go into the hat, and we'll give you the winner before 3 o'clock today. But first, I do want to talk about Bus Eireann. And as you know, many of you today listening have been discommoded in some way. But do you support the strike? From midnight, an immediate all-out strike of Bus Eireann began, and the National Bus and Rail Union said in a statement that all five unions representing workers had met in relation to the letter sent by Bus Eireann workers detailing cost-cutting measures that were to be implemented immediately. They decided that they had no alternative but to strike. Well, they did have an alternative, which was not to strike, but however, they decided to strike. The state-owned transport company, or, well, there's arguments over this. We had a big argument in the office earlier on today as we used the word state-owned. It's kind of semi-state. It's sponsored by the state. In other words, the state subvents it. Last year, faced losses of €10 million, which means the state has to pay that €10 million. That's your tax money. Bus Eireann should be able to run commercially, just like all other private operators. But there are always going to be those routes that are not financially viable, and we have to have them. But there are other routes that make a lot of profit. So it should all balance out if we do it properly. But we're not doing it properly. They're not doing it properly, it seems. Bus Eireann says it needs to make changes to employee contracts to keep the company viable. And I've heard stories of some drivers and some workers getting twice as much as maybe private workers running similar routes. And I'm not suggesting the private workers are well paid, but I know today is not probably a good idea because a lot of people are going to go to the private operators today because they can't get a Bus Eireann bus and they might actually like it. So Bus Eireann could lose a lot of money today and lose a lot of customers. Now, to make this bus company viable, it will include job losses, changes to bus routes, cuts in overtime, and a range of other measures. In addition to this, Irish Rail has said this morning and advised customers that there will be significant disruption to its intercity rail services today arising from picketing associated with the bus strike. I don't know why. It's a separate organisation. Why they're actually coming out in protest with Bus Eireann, that'll be like RTE going on strike and us deciding we'll go on strike too, you know, just to support them. Which doesn't make any difference or any sense. Now, the Irish Rail spokesperson Barry Kenny told RTE this morning that in a number of locations, as there are pickets that its employees decided not to pass, adding that it had been hoped that the company would have far more extensive rail services today. Now, the company is advising that there are and there will be no services today on the following routes: Cork Commuter, Waterford to Limerick Junction, Limerick to Galway, Limerick to Ballybrophy, via Nina, and Tralee to Mallow. So a lot of our listeners from all those areas are going to be really badly affected today. And he also advised, Barry Kenny said, that refunds will be given to customers who have booked tickets in advance, but Irish Rail would not compensate customers for alternative journeys they may have to make as a result of the reduced services. Why not? You set up a business, you promise somebody something, they buy a monthly ticket and they can't use your service because you're on strike. Refund them. Give them their money back. He added that workers who refuse to pass the picket will not be paid. So essentially, some Irish Rail workers are choosing not to pass the picket in support of Bus Eireann workers. But I want to know today if you support the strike. Have you been affected by the strike today? Maybe you have. Thousands and thousands of commuters all across the country were put out of place today as this kind of snap strike got underway. We didn't get much warning of this. Many people did not have an alternative route or an alternative way to get to work because it wasn't a planned strike. Maybe you support them and you think they have every right to strike for their rights. Or maybe you think, like me, you were sick of hearing about strike after strike after strike. So here's the simple question. Do you support the strike? So I want you to text 53544. Do you support it? Yes, you do, or no, you don't. Let's take a little vote on it and see how many people actually support it, because I'm looking at some of the comments online. They don't seem to be getting a huge amount of support. Yes, you support them, or no, you don't. Let me know what you think. Text your answer now to 53544. We'll do a little text poll, all right? If you want to give us a ring, you can. The number is 1850 410 494. Stephen, you're on Classic Hits. How are you doing, Stephen?
Good afternoon, Niall.
Good afternoon. Stephen, do you support the strike?
No, I'm with you, Niall. I'm sick of me teeth of his strikes and everybody jumping on the bandwagon. Just because he knows that the country's getting a little bit better. It's not back to where it should be, but it's getting a little better. And if the employees want to close down this company, they're going down the right way, because they're just driving customers into other people's hands.
So you believe they're going to do themselves out of the job and end up on the dole here?
Yeah, absolutely. Sure, all the people now that need services will go on to the private buses, and they'll realise that it's a better, cheaper service, and that'll be that.
I did hear one worker there on the Vox Pop on news earlier on suggesting that, you know, life is getting tougher, his kids are in college now, he needs more money, and obviously with the cuts to overtime, etc., he's going to be getting possibly less money. Well, mind you, overtime is never guaranteed. I don't know where people get this idea that they're guaranteed a certain amount of overtime.
Well, in the public sector, I know it's not fully public sector, but they just expect overtime all the time. Now.
Mm-hmm.
That's not guaranteed. That's a bonus.
Well, it is, yeah.
It shouldn't be put into your budget for a year or anything like that, because it's only a bonus. You shouldn't be depending on something that's not going to be there.
Well, their argument as well is that, you know, unless they strike, well, you know, Bus Eireann are going to have to make changes because they have to save money. The state can't afford to keep putting money into this bus service. I don't know how we can't manage to run it properly, but they're going to keep putting money into it. The 10 million last year, I think it was 6 million the year before. God only knows what it'll be next year. So they have to make cuts over time, maybe staff losses, reduction of hours, changing in routes. Do you believe they should just roll in behind the company and try to do their best?
Yeah, if they want to save their jobs, this is the only way. So we all had to do it 10 years ago, Niall. They've got away with it over the last 10 years. And they're still on wages that some of us dream of, you know.
Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of them would be a lot higher paid than private work, than private bus routes, absolutely.
And that's the whole reason why they can't move forward, Niall. Their pay demands are ridiculous.
All right, well, we'll stay there for a second. The contract, obviously, they want to change them too. John, you're on Classic Hits. How are you doing, John?
Hi, how are you?
John, you support the strike.
I do, and just on Stephen's point there, we said, take the worst case scenario, no, Niall, right? We said that this gets completely entrenched, right? And it lasts more than one day, goes to a second day, a third day, goes to a week. And we say worst case scenario that the company was wound up, right? How can you disband the whole nation's transport system, right? And I guarantee you this, we say again, worst case scenario, that there's no CIE buses leaving Cork, right? That the whole thing is wound up. No, I can't see that happening, but we'll say if it did, right? Do you think we'll imagine that the private operators would be allowed to leave Cork City or any other city? Because all the workers, and I would stand with them, and the people of Cork, I would block and stand every private operator then, would not be allowed to move any bus out of the city.
But you're missing the point, John. Private operators currently run at a profit, otherwise they wouldn't be in business, right? So if they can run routes at a profit, why can't Bus Eireann do it? Because the conditions and the contracts and the salaries are higher?
But you see, the problem is they come in, the private buses won't take anyone with disabilities, any passes, any pensioners.
Absolutely, but hang on, but Bus Eireann are being subsidised to do that anyway. And they, because they have more routes, the, you know, the profitable routes should pay for the loss-making routes.
Well, as I said, it's like the whole thing with the bins and everything. Like, I mean, the bins became privatised. I mean, or the waivers went out the window. The same thing would happen if the whole thing was privatised in the morning. And you cannot, look, just because there's areas that are not profitable right around this country, are you going to disband, just discommode all those people?
I'm not saying that that's what you should do. But at the end of the day, you have to be able to run. I mean, look, it's a small bus company in comparison to, say, some of the European bus companies, right? It's fairly small. I mean, we're only a small bloody island.
Well,
still can't manage to run it properly.
Well, I mean, that'll tell us the people like, I mean, that have been running the system within the bus service themselves and the Department of Transport and the government for years. We've got an impotent minister at the moment for transport, Shane Ross, who's an absolute disgrace.
Why? Because he won't give them more money. He said, work it out amongst yourselves, basically.
Look, he's made statements like, I'm not going to go in waving a checkbook, right?
No, but he can't, because it's not his checkbook. It's your checkbook and Stephen's checkbook and Billy's checkbook and my checkbook. That's our taxes.
But that checkbook, like, I mean, the money that checkbook contains, right, that money belongs to the Irish taxpayer.
Yeah, but there isn't a bucket of money in the door that you can just keep taking money out and handing it to public sector all the time. You just can't keep doing that.
If you park him in his wallet or his checkbook for a second, right, the man isn't even engaging, like, I mean, he's an absolute disaster.
But hang on, when you say he's not engaging, he's basically saying, work it out yourselves. We're paying 10 million. We've already paid 10 million in losses this year from state, which is from your taxes, right?
Well, I tell you what we do.
He's not paying any more.
Yeah, by the end of business today, so we should disband the office, right, so of Minister of Transport. It doesn't exist anymore, because if we have got a Minister of Transport that won't engage, we don't need him.
But you're missing the point. He has engaged. He's engaged to the point of saying there's nothing more we can do. We can't keep pumping money into it.
But sir, he's not even going to meetings, like, I mean, or anything. He's done a
and I'm not quoting him there, by the way. I'm paraphrasing. All right.
Yeah, he's done a Pontius Pilate on it, really. He's washed his hands.
What are you talking about, a Pontius Pilate? What more can he say? What do you want him to do? Negotiate? Hang on, Stephen. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, he should replace all these routes and give out the private contracts, Niall. And in the private contract, make it a part of the contract that the people who need bus services get on at a discounted rate, or else they have their bus passes. And do not give them the contracts until that's solid in the contract.
But they won't acknowledge the waivers of the bus passes.
But sure, the bus drivers won't acknowledge the situation they're in.
But sure, how could you take a 32% cut in your wages?
I had to do it about 10 years ago, John.
Yeah, but
All of us did.
Yeah, but we've moved on now, Mr. Prime Minister of our country and the Kenyans forever are telling us that we've turned the corner.
That's rubbish. John, you'll be on moaning about the homelessness next. So what is this pot of gold you think that's in the government?
But look,
handing it out fist over foot all the time. It drives me bananas. I pay nearly 70 grand in personal taxes a year. It drives me nuts.
Yeah, of course, yeah. But the thing is, you just can't abandon the transport system of rural Ireland.
But hang on, who's saying abandon it? Nobody has said we need to abandon it. They're just saying you've got to run it more profitably.
But so we've been told now, like, I mean, if there's an impasse at the moment, like, and it's possibly, you know, that the whole thing will be wound up. How can you wind up the transport?
Well, I mean, the biggest problem, from what I believe, is the Swift buses. The Swift buses are the biggest loss-making buses, I believe.
The one from Ashbourne, Noel, every day I see it going by me, and there'll be one or two people on the bus, and it says on the bus 150 services a day.
But we say, Noel, there's a bus coming out from Cork tonight, now we're sitting out to Ballyfihan, right? I mean, I'm in the talk of Ballyfihan area, right? I'm in between, right? But the thing is, there might be two people on the bus at 10 o'clock or 10:30 come out tonight. Do you think one of those two people are being facilitated? Do you think that a private operator is going to bring two people from Patrick Street to Ballyfihan?
Well, if they have to, it depends on the contracts they're given as a private operator. And just to clarify, the National Bus and Rail Union has said the pay rise offer was 1% to 3%, so we'll say 2%, averaging 2%, all right, was insulting, given the proposed cuts which could reduce pay by 25%. Now, when they use this figure of 25%, you said 32 a minute ago, but when they use this figure of 25%, they're talking about, for example, the cuts in overtime. Now, as Stephen rightly said, when you start a job and, you know, somebody says to you, right, you're on 40 grand a year, but listen, you know, there will be a lot of overtime I imagine. You don't, that you take it that you're getting 40 grand and everything else is going to be a bonus. You can't be taking overtime for granted.
But you see, the trouble is, like, if it's ongoing, anyone's overtime is ongoing for a long period of time now, it becomes part then of your budget.
But
it shouldn't. It shouldn't.
Yeah.
But it does, because you budget for that money, because if you're getting it...
Well, that's your stupidity, John, I have to say. That's your stupidity, because...
John, I get a bonus here, you know, around May at the end of my contract every year, depending on the ratings, okay? Now, but if the ratings aren't as good as they should have been for the last year, I don't get that bonus. But I don't factor it into my yearly budget, because I don't know if I'm going to get it or not.
Well, look, I'm doing my best for your ratings.
Okay, but don't get me wrong, before anyone starts jumping down my throat, it's not much, right? But it's a few quid, right? You know what I mean? They'll pay for a holiday ticket or something like that, right?
Yeah,
but I don't factor it in. I can't. Because factor it in and I don't get it, you know, I'm going to be disappointed. So you don't factor in overtime, you don't factor in bonuses, you just factor in your basic salary and that's it. And you know, everything else after that becomes a bonus. Now, don't get me wrong, I have sympathy for them losing the overtime. I do. But the company just cannot sustain it. It can't.
But let's be honest, I mean, as I said again, what are you going to do? Wind the whole thing up? Is this, I mean, are you going to abandon rural Ireland? I mean, are you going to cut back the buses in the cities and we'll have only one every...
No, that's not going to happen either. That can't happen. And that's why they're saying that they have to make these cutbacks. Nobody's suggesting abandoning rural Ireland. They are obviously talking about changing certain routes. They're not going to abandon rural Ireland. There will still be routes which will not be profitable.
If the former Prime Minister of this country can leave his mother's gravesite and all that with the anguish that he had in his heart that day, in fairness to him, like, and go all the way 100 miles up to the north of Ireland to continue on the talks up there, and you have this asshole Shane Ross, and he won't get up off his hole and talk to anyone.
All right, well, stay there for a second. Billy, I'm going to come to you in a second, if you could please wait for me. I just want to go to Julian first, if I can. Julian, you're on Classic Hits. Go ahead, Julian.
Niall, how's it going?
Julian, what do you want to say to John there? Go ahead.
Your man there, like the guy, your man from Cork, what's his name, John, is it?
John, yeah.
It seems that every strike that's going, every time where he feels that the workers are being misrepresented and hard done by, he comes on with this kind of cap in hand attitude of, and we'll block the route of Cork. Don't be so ridiculous. Do you think that these people are going to line up and block the route out of Cork because he feels they should be blocked? It's terrible that people's wages have to be cut. But it's very black and white. If a service or a company or whatever isn't making a profit, the company can't keep running at a loss. And the taxpayer can't keep forking out the money to subsidise the thing. I work in the private sector, and I have to take the good with the bad, you know?
We could fork out $2 billion for Irish Water.
Ah, oh, stop, John.
John,
you can't keep pulling that argument out of the hat all the time. We're past that.
Well, if you've got the stuff needed to the government that cost a fortune, that'll never be used.
The old Irish Water, that's got to be used for years. Like the voting machines, that'll be used for years as well. But Julian, what about the workers who say, you know, look, we've taken into consideration that we get overtime, or we get these extra routes, or we get the, you know, these shift rates, or whatever it is they happen to be getting, and we can't afford to lose that money, up to 25% possibly?
You can.
I understand losing any percent of your wage.
And by the way, they won't all lose it, let me be clear about that.
But if it's not in your contract, if you sign the contract, and it's not the black and white, you will get X amount of overtime or X amount of a bonus. Like, if it's not written there and it's taken away from you, as much as a paid as it is, and, you know, it makes you angry, you know, you've signed a contract, there's nothing you can do. Like, in my line of work, Jesus, it is the hours I work, but I'm not complaining about it. I do what I do when I've chosen this job. I like my job. I do what I do when I work hard. If I have a gripe, or the people I work with have a gripe with the situation we're in, we don't just, you know, tools down and out the doors down outside with placards. People wouldn't get any support. It's, as you said, the strike after strike after strike after strike after strike after strike. Like, the trains are on strike. What's that got to do with the buses?
I didn't get that this morning, John. What had the train drivers got to do with the buses?
Well, this morning there was...
That's like a hospital going on strike because I'm on strike. It doesn't make any sense.
Well, they're doing it in solidarity for a while.
Solidarity, the arse. They're a separate company. Nothing to do with them. All they're doing is pissing off the general public. Can you not see that?
No, the trains were back on at 11, leaving from Cork again, right? But there was a bit of solidarity at the start. And I heard the spokesperson today at another station saying that, like, it was sending a message out to the government, like, I mean, don't take us for granted, like, I mean, that we will back our brothers and our sisters, you know?
Okay, well, stay there, please, Julian. Let me go to Billy. Billy, you're on Classic Kids. How are you doing, Billy?
How you doing, yeah? No, I support the workers 100%. It's bad management. It's always the workers that have to suffer. They get us around the city safely. They do. I'd like to see management take a call. I'd like to see the coach being implemented at the top first. It's always the guy down the bottom and bringing the ladder, isn't it?
Well, I would imagine if they're going to be making cuts overall, yeah, they will have to be cutting management as well.
No, but they don't. No, they don't. See, every time there's a strike, and Stephen says the strike after strike. It's not strike after strike. It's, as John says, we're told that things are on the up. Andy Kenny keeps on telling us many times that we're on the up and stuff. And these guys, was listening to them today. They've got bills for the next 20 years. And the other lads on the line, would they, like, the chap in the private sector there, now, if his boss came up to him tomorrow and told him that he has to take 30% pay cut, so he'd be...
No, hang on. You're saying a 30% pay cut. They're actually offering them a 1% to 3% pay rise. Yeah. They're just saying there's not going to be as much overtime.
But I'm just saying, if he was asked to take, say, 20 or 25, I don't know what company he works for, but just say his company were doing really bad, would he be willing to take it? I don't think he would now, somehow.
Well, he can answer that himself.
I've been in this situation before where I've had pay cuts. Did I like it? No. And if I'm in a situation where pay cut comes too bad, where I think it's too much to deal with, you know, and it's happened from time to time, then I look at my options.
Yeah,
and I don't decide to rally around the troops and then say, one out, all out.
It's just, if you have no options.
You know, everyone goes down about empathy with the workers. Have any, like, these strikes, have they had an effect on you directly?
No, see, I'm supposed to be going to Galway next week, right? And I would have been going on the bus or the train. But it's no big deal. I'll get a private bus. And if they're all booked out, it's no big deal. I get a lift in a car. But
I don't mean, like, are you going for a social trip or is it a work-related trip?
No, it's social, but if it was
a work-related trip, have any of you had it affect you, your work, for your livelihood?
Yeah, I was working in Galway.
You've been affected by these people not wanting to provide you with the service they've signed up to provide you with.
I mean, let me give you an example or an analogy, Billy, right? So I'm hired by Classic Kids 4FM to do, say, 5 days a week, right?
Mm.
And that's in my contract, you know, for a year. I have to do so many shows in a year, right?
Yeah.
So let's say my boss, Andy, turns around and says, listen, Niall, the guy on Saturday, he's taken off, he's leaving the country. Can you do Saturdays for us as well? I'll give you an extra 100 quid or whatever, right? And I say, that's grand. So I'm doing it for 6 months, and that's great. I'm getting an extra 100 quid a week. Well, happy days. And then he turns around and then about 6 months later and says, listen, we've got somebody for that Saturday now. We don't need you anymore. Should I go on strike? It's not in my contract. I was taking it for granted. I got an extra 100 quid a week. Should I go on strike now?
No, but I'm just
that's the analogy here.
Yeah,
because
but I'm just saying to that chap, if his boss came up to him and I told him to take 25% pay cut.
But the way you... you're wording it out of context. Nobody's been asked to take a pay cut. People are being told there's going to be less overtime, so there's not going to be as much money. I understand that. And not everybody's going to lose the overtime, by the way. Some will. Yeah. They're asked for cutbacks.
But
Billy, you're missing the biggest point. Yeah. It's not viable. It's just not viable.
But Niall, if this happens, then next year they'll come back to them and they'll want something else. It's never ending.
But they're looking for they've been offered 1% to 3%. They're not happy with that. The company just wants to be... Well, the government just wants the company to be reasonably profitable. They don't mind subventing it because they have to subvent it for bus passes and, free travel, et cetera, et cetera. So they have to. Medical cards, all that kind of stuff.
Now, do you know the bus passes?
Yeah.
They want everyone that has a bus pass. They reckon there's 1.2 million that have bus passes. They want everyone to pay €6.
That was one of the suggestions to try and make a bit of money to help the company. I don't think that went through the dollar. And that was one of the suggestions by one of the ministers.
Either free travel or it's not.
Well, look, you want everything, Billy. You want the free travel, you want the routes that don't make money, you want the workers to get all their money. The money isn't in the kitty to do all that. Stay there, please, guys. Going to come to Claire as well after the break. Keep texting 53544, okay? I'll be honest with you, it's about a 50-50 split so far. If I look back through the text, there's a lot of no's actually when I come to think of it. I'll give you the exact result after the break. Okay, keep texting 53544. Do you support the Bus Eireann and the rail strike at the moment as well, while some of the rail services are down? Text 53544. Yes, you do, or no, you don't support it.
Have you got an opinion? What's on your mind? Call 1850-410-494. Niall Boylan. Real Talk Radio. Classic Hits 4FM. Gareth O'Callaghan in the afternoon.
Well, when it comes to classic hits, Friday's set list looks like an absolute list of gems. Join me at 3 o'clock on Friday during the show. One lucky Leaving Cert or Junior Cert student is going to win an Easter revision course package. It includes five courses from Julie Kilmartin's five-star revision courses in Ennis and Limerick. Just for Laughs is worth €290, and it's day five of Mission 21 in aid of the Down Syndrome Centre. How high can we go? Join me Friday at 3 to find out.
With the Tesco Community Fund, over €2 million donated to local causes chosen by you. Classic Hits. 4 FM.
This week at Centra, we have great offers, like Centra Fresh Irish Pork Loin Roast, now half price. Spoil your mum this Mother's Day with Griffon Prosecco Frizzante, now €9. Cadbury Roses Carton and Nestle Quality Street Bag, both half price. And Thursday to Sunday only, Lion's Tea 80-pack, also half price. Centra, live every day. Enjoy alcohol sensibly.
You can have a rewarding career as a neuromuscular therapist. Study at the National Training Centre, a proven experience leader in chronic pain and physical therapy education, with part-time courses available in Dublin, Cork, Galway and Waterford. For details, call 01-882-7777 or go to ntc.ie.
NTC, see who you can be. So you hire a car for holidays at a great price. Brilliant. Then you get to the car hire desk abroad only to be told the excess is not included. And then they tell you the excess will be double your car hire price. Be smart. Don't get ripped off abroad. Before you travel, cover your excess with carhireexcess.com for only $2.99 a day or $49.99 a year. Price quoted is European cover per persons aged 21 to 84 with a full licence. Blue Insurance Limited, trading as carhireexcess.com, is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland.
A confident new life. A great new look. The best in professional hair transplants. Natural looking hair that lasts. You can find all that at MHR Clinic. And now, find MHR Clinic on Grafton Street, conveniently located at the heart of Dublin, delivering honest advice and the latest exclusive treatments to combat hair loss, all at an affordable price and with some treatments that can even be done in a day. MHR Clinic, at the top of Grafton Street, or mhrclinicireland.com.
The Olympia Theatre proudly presents Paul Carrick in a fully seated headline performance on the 18th of October.
Satisfy my soul.
Tickets €36 on sale now. Additional charges may apply in certain circumstances.
Take it to extreme. There must have been an angel.
Paul Carrick, live at the Olympia this October.
Now ready for spring. Tobermore Paving and Walling Centres in Dublin and Cork have everything you need to create your dream patio or driveway. We offer a wide range of paving bricks, paving flags and walling to suit all budgets and the expert advice needed to get you started. Also, our landscape design services can transform your home into a unique, distinctive paradise. And with countrywide delivery throughout Ireland, what's stopping you? Call in to the Tobermore Paving and Walling Centres in Dublin and Cork or visit tobermore.ie. More quality like no other. J.K. Rowling invites you back to the wizarding world before Harry Potter.
First trip to New York?
Yes.
Where a Newt Scamander arrived with a suitcase of magical beasts and changed the course of magic in America forever.
Why should I help you instead of turning you in?
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. To own on DVD and Blu-ray from March 24th at Supervalue. See in store for details.
Hi, I'm Dermot Gavin. Don't miss an exclusive edition of my book, The Extra Room, free inside this week's Sunday World. An inspiring step-by-step guide to creating the garden of your dreams. Plus, the golden rules of design to help make your outdoor space work for you and your family. Only in the Sunday World, the People's Paper.
The PPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show.
All right, SIP2 described the proposals by Bus Eireann as being totally horrendous and totally unacceptable. The union also said that a mandate for industrial action may have to be activated, which it is. But in a letter to the staff, Bus Eireann CEO Ray Heronan warned the staff that the company will go out of business if its financial difficulties are not addressed. They can't keep making losses. Massive losses. They're obviously going to make losses of some stage. I mean, there has to be subvention. He said the required changes including cuts in premium payments, overtime, rates, rota and shift payments and allowances. And here's one that actually intrigues me. In future, he says, sick benefits will only be calculated on basic pay. Why, what were they calculated on before? Why, do they calculate sick pay? Does it include shift rates and overtime? He also said staff will have to accept redeployment and what he calls reasonable changes to roles and responsibilities. You know, like, when a company is in trouble, a lot of us would have experienced this 10 years ago when the recession kicked in, people have to pull together. And I hate to keep using the radio station as an analogy, but like every other radio station in the country, staff numbers have gone down in the last 10 years, not up. Even though the radio business is expanding in somewhat, the staff numbers went down. So more people have to do more jobs. You've got to do other roles. And everybody has to pull together as a team to make it work, because it's in your own interest to keep a bloody job, isn't it? Keep texting 53544. Somebody says Shane Ross wasn't long about hopping on a plane over to Brazil to help his mate. Yeah, he wasn't long about hopping on the plane and coming back either. Keep texting 53544. Oh, by the way, can I mention as well, our Down Syndrome Centre total so far is €26,004. We could actually hit 30,000 by 3 o'clock today. So keep texting DSC to 50300, okay? DSC to 50300. Remember, the text costs you €4, all right? Goes to the Down Syndrome Centre. We'll get more. I'm going to push you a little bit harder in the second hour on that. We need to get to 30 grand, okay? Before 2 o'clock today, or before 3 o'clock today. All right, let me go to Claire on Classic Kids. How are you doing, Claire?
Hi, Niall. I'm grand, thank you.
Okay, Claire, now you were kind of put out by the strike today, were you?
Yeah, I had an early morning appointment to get blood tests done in the regional hospital.
Right.
And because of the strike, our city buses were gone. Normally it takes 2 buses to get out to the hospital and 2 buses back. And I've an appointment in Dublin in 2 weeks' time in the hospital as well. And I'm hoping that this strike doesn't go on, because I've been waiting 3 years for an appointment.
So this could really do you a lot of harm as well. You've waited so long for this appointment and you can't even get there.
Yeah, I have a disability and I have the free travel as well. And without the free travel, I would be lost.
You'd be stuck in the house all day. Yeah.
Go to the hospitals and things like that. But some of the private buses do, especially cabinets, the rapid buses, they do take people with, mobility, if you're physically...
And are you in a wheelchair, are you?
No, I have a physical disability, but I'm also now on one of those mobile trolleys that we use for doing.
All right, a mobility scooter, is that what they call it?
Yeah.
Okay, so you obviously need the ramp or the lower step and all that kind of stuff, don't you? And you need to get on and off.
10 years ago, CIE took the local bus off on one of our routes, which mainly people used for going to the hospitals. They gave it to another area. They've improved the timetables and the buses, but at the moment, when they go on strike like this, it just comes to a standstill.
All right, listen, Claire. Well, there you go. There's Claire being affected. And as you can see, the strikes do affect people who are more vulnerable in certain circumstances. Thanks for that, Claire. Let me go to Katrina. Katrina, you're on Classic Hits. How are you doing, Katrina?
Oh, hi, Niall. How are you?
Katrina, there was no trains in Galway.
I live in Athenry. We don't get a 11:30 train. I have a point like that later in the region, 1:30. No train to Point Castry. It's a joke, like.
Right, okay. But who do you blame for all that?
I blame the workers.
The workers, okay, so you're blaming the workers. Okay, so
they're getting enough of money, they should have come up and strike the trains, and nobody knows about it. I'm going to wait now 6 months for another appointment. I'm fizzled.
Right, okay, so and what are you going to do then if you can't get out then? You're going to have to try and get a taxi or something?
No, I had to cancel the appointment. I couldn't get there for half past one.
Right, okay. And was there many people waiting there today? Was there many people waiting?
There was. I was getting 11:30 because I had to get a bus out to the hospital when I come off the train to UHD. Right. And there was loads of people waiting. Never told none of us. And I was in the train yesterday when Tinkle told us yesterday.
Right, okay.
They
didn't know, unfortunately. Most people didn't know until yesterday evening the strike was going to happen at midnight last night, so they didn't kind of know. Let me go to Morris. Morris, you're on Classic Kids. How are you doing, Morris?
How you doing, Niall?
Morris, you support the strikers?
I support the concept of having workers' rights, particularly in the transport sector. Do I support a strike today involving Irish Rail as well? Absolutely not. I'd just like to point out, my point to Helena there earlier was that there is actually unfair competition in the actual bus, the actual passenger transport industry here. You have all these private companies who have set up along the most profitable lines. They have been given licences by the National Transport Authority to operate in competition with Bus Eireann. Now, I know a friend of mine, close personal friend. I'm a lorry driver, I should explain that. He is actually a lorry driver as well. He went off about 2 years ago, maybe 3 years ago, and got himself a bus licence. Now, he'd put an awful lot of work and money and effort into it. I think he spent about €3,000 to get this licence in the end. But he's still driving trucks. And I met him recently and asked him, like, I thought you were going off to drive buses. And he said to me, look, it wouldn't pay me unless I got in to Bus Eireann. And I said, what do you mean? Like, I said, there's all these other companies, like. And he said, look, I went for an interview. I won't name the company now. That I went for an interview. They were willing to give me a job, he said. But what the pay they were offering me was €10 an hour based on a 50-hour working week with no overtime. No, you know, every hour of the 50 hours would be €10 an hour. So he said, for working a 50-hour week...
He's getting 500 basic, yeah.
Before tax, you know. And he said, sure, that's not good. That wouldn't pay me. He said, sure, like, I have that for a 40-hour week driving the truck.
Yeah.
Do you know, I mean, you have that going on. And, like, the way I look at it, if you're going to allow competition, at least the playing field should be level. There should have been some sort of safety measure in terms of, you know, like before we had employment agreements here where construction workers were only paid a certain amount of money, they couldn't be paid less than that. You know, you had all these things a couple of years ago, right?
And do the private routes, well, some of the private routes, mm-hmm. are they not, you know, obliged in their contract to cover routes that wouldn't be quite as profitable?
No, it's like this. You apply for a licence. You want a licence to operate a service. Let's say, for argument's sake, between Dublin and Cork. You're either granted it or you're not. You're mm-hmm. not going to say, I want to operate an expressway route. There's no actual licence from the NTA that says, you must drive through all these towns and stop at these locations. You get the licence to operate between the two cities, right? Which means you can pick up passengers here in Cork. You don't have to use the bus station, which is another contentious issue. Here on Patrick's Quay in Cork, there is an unofficial bus station being operated by these private contractors, right?
We have it here in Dublin too, along the quays, yeah. yeah.
And
yeah.
it's a disgrace that they're allowed to do it, right? Because it causes traffic mayhem as well. No.
But can I say something to you? When you look at Bus Eireann, they've a lot of profitable routes, a lot of them, yeah. right? But they have a lot of routes they make no money on, and a lot of routes they lose money on. Mm-hmm. But it's up to management to work out how to pass the money from one to the other to make everything mm-hmm. profitable. And we understand they're never going to make a profit, okay? Because, of course, they have to use the free bus passes and all that kind of stuff as well. So it's never going to be profitable, right? And the government is obliged to, you know, subvent it in some way. But we can't... I mean, look at the subvention at the moment. It's getting ridiculous. 10 million last year. I mean, you can't continue to do that.
I think it's more than 10 million, to be quite honest with you.
Was it 6 the year before, 10 last year? Yeah.
You know, it's crazy money. And look...
It's getting worse.
There's a railway line, and I know it's a CIE, it's an Irish Rail one, right? But it's a CIE group company. You have the railway line, there's the Limerick to Ballybrophy, right? It's just a sieve. It's not a bucket for money, it's a sieve. You put money in and it just flows out the end, right? There is nobody using the service. It costs the state €550
per passenger.
I heard that,
yeah.
So if you take a return journey on this,
would it not be cheaper to take each passenger to put each passenger in a taxi? It would be cheaper.
Put them in a bloody bus,
yeah,
and go down the railway line, you know, and these are the sort of things. Look, I work in little.
You're preaching to the converted. What you're telling me is makes perfect sense, but they're not making sense. They're not listening. You've got the government saying to them, look, we're putting enough money into this. You just need to fix the problem. And they're not listening. Well, do me a favour, stay there for a second. Let me just go to Mike. I was going to break. Mike, can you just wait after the break? And I'll go to his first caller after the break. All right, stay there, Mike. Keep texting 53544. Do you support the bus strike today?
Real people. Real opinions. Real talk radio. The Niall Boylan Show.
Hi, it's Jim McCabe. Join me for CSI Sunday this week as we remember the hits and headlines of more classic years. This week, it's the year that this was one of the big sports stories.
The start of the opening round, Muhammad Ali, Al Blue Lewis, here in Croke Park, Dublin.
And these were some of the classic hits.
Hold me closer, time to dance. You're so vain.
We'll have this and more classic years on CSI Sunday. Join me, Jim McCabe, Sunday evening from 6.
CSI.
Classic Song Investigation.
Classic Hits 4FM.
Choose Dunn Stores for better value every day.
Save €10 on every €50 spent using your Shop and Save vouchers. That's on top of great half-price offers. Like Nestlé Shreddies 1kg, now just $2.99. Lucozade Energy 6-pack range, now only $2.44. Doritos Sharing range, now from $1.29. Surf Liquid Detergents 40 Wash, an amazing $5.40. And Comfort Creations Fabric Conditioner 33 Wash, an incredible $2.37. All half price. Dunn Stores, always better value. Terms and conditions apply.
Whoever said you shouldn't follow your heart never experienced the thrill of driving an Audi A6. And with smart finance solutions and a low monthly APR rate now available, there's never been a better time to buy your new Audi A6. So now you can follow your heart and your head. Audi. Vorsprung durch Technik. Audi Finance is a trading style of Volkswagen Bank GmbH Branch Ireland, authorised by the Federal Financial Supervisory Authority in Germany and regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland for conduct of business rules.
This March in Home Store and More, all wall mirrors and clocks are half price, all Pyrex kitchen and cookware is half price, and all clothing storage is half price. But better hurry, because when all the half price wall mirrors and clocks are gone, they're gone. And when all the half price Pyrex kitchen and cookware is gone, it's gone too. And as for all the half price clothing storage, when it's gone, it's definitely gone. All offers available online at homestoreandmore.ie, as well as in-store at Home Store and More. Home Store and More is now open in Turner's Cross Retail Park in Cork. Home Store and More. Believe what we say. More savings every day.
Don't miss a minute of America when you fly Shannon to Boston, Chicago, New York, Newark, New York State, Providence, and Philadelphia. Enjoy hassle-free pre-clearance, direct flights, and connections to over 250 cities across the USA. Fly Shannon. It's easier. Explore more at shannonairport.ie.
Celebrate the 40th anniversary of Saturday Night Fever with Nights on Broadway. The Bee Gees story live on stage at Dublin's Vicar Street on Easter Sunday, April 16th. Relive the glory days when disco ruled the world and the Bee Gees were its kings. Tickets €30, including booking fees, from Ticketmaster outlets nationwide.
Oh, this sounds a bit daft, man. You know, to say it like this, but it's nice to see you. I mean, it's nice to have you back.
See yourself in the mirror, not your psoriasis. Dovenex Psoriasis Ointment can help you see a difference in your psoriasis in as early as 2 weeks, and now it's available direct from your pharmacist. So at the first sign of a flare-up, try Dovenex Psoriasis Ointment and love your skin again. Contains calcipotrol for mild to moderate plaque psoriasis diagnosed by a doctor. Always read the label.
At M&S this weekend, you can dine in with us for just €14. Choose a delicious main course with sides for two, a dessert for two, and a bottle of wine from a selection of products, all for just €14. Only M&S. Selected products in stores subject to availability. Enjoy wine responsibly. Offer runs Wednesday to Tuesday.
The PPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show.
All right, so the comments coming in. The union should be required to compensate Irish Rail for the loss of revenue in full. And a person says, well done to Éireann Rod Éireann workers showing solidarity and refusing to cross a picket. To all the Bus Eireann workers, remember the union won't be there to help you when you're on the dole queue. Irish Rail drivers calling doing their jobs, passing the picket, is one hell of a reach, says somebody else. And a person says, this is an interesting one, actually, just want to read this one out if I can find it. Oh yeah, Niall Boylan, you were saying that overtime is not part of a basic wage, which is correct. But it didn't stop you and the rest of the media saying that the Lewis drivers were on 40k or 50k per year, when most were on an average industrial wage of 35 plus overtime to bring them up to 50k. Well, that's incorrect, actually. They were on between 35 and 50k, depending on how long their service was. So maybe you got that a little bit mixed up. But in any case, no one ever quoted the overtime, which is a lot of extra hours work. Total hypocrisy. And just because people have their own terms and conditions cut in the race to the bottom over the last few years. What are you talking about, race to the bottom, Tom? You know, I mean, if you look back, for example, when the recession came in first, I think Irish Rail got a rise at the time when everyone else was getting pay cuts. Let me go to Mike. Mike, you're on Classic Hits. Go ahead, Mike.
How you doing?
Good, Mike.
Really and truly, I'd just like to say that your analysis of anyone that's on strike.
That's on what? Sorry, say that again, Mike.
Your analysis of the situation, not only for people on industrial action, but your analysis is your hatred for these people.
I don't have any hatred for anybody.
You do. You actually despise these people.
Oh, I know them all personally.
They're taking industrial action.
No, I'm upset because of the way they've discommoded their passengers and the people who pay their wages.
Look, do you remember that old saying? Don't buy anything British but their cotton or their coal or something like that.
Well, the guaranteed Irish thing, was it?
Well, people are going to be put on people are going to be discommoded in industrial action. It's like all
and that's and by the way, that's fair enough, provided we believe that the industrial action is justified. But many people, hang on, Mike, many people believe it's not warranted.
Well, many, but of course you're going to get the people that you know, but it is justified. They're looking out for their future.
Well, in your opinion, hang on, in your opinion it's justified, but in many other people's opinions it's not.
Well, then, all right, let me ask you another question.
Well, I can tell you now, Mike, their future is looking very bleak at the moment. Well, either way.
Can I tell you something? You keep saying about the company being on the verge of insolvency and all that. But if you
Well, I'm not saying that. Their CEO is saying that, yeah.
Well, okay, Coffey's saying it. He's on 500 grand a year.
Well, he's saying it because it's his job to speak out on behalf of the company and to look after the company's finances, yeah.
It's his job to make that company...
And if he can't make that company profitable and nobody else can, well, then something has to break.
But the only reason they're making it profitable is by driving down wages. That's the only way they're doing it.
But when you say driving down wages, they're reducing... Now, not everybody's overtime. They will reduce overtime. They will have to call what they call reasonable changes to roles and responsibilities.
Look,
In other words, you remember that nonsense that went around at the time about the Lewis strike, that if a driver was told to change from the green line to the red line, he had to get a €100 shift pay or something like that. Just maybe, I don't know if they ever got that, but that's what they were looking for. In other words, what he's saying is the silliness has to stop.
My interpretation of that was actually that the company were making the drivers on the Lewis that were based at the green line walk all the way at 4 o'clock in the morning or transport them to the red line. The red line.
Well, transport them, yeah.
They were doing it on purpose. They were actually... These people that run these organisations, like one of your...
I don't think they were doing anything on purpose to piss people off. I doubt that very much, in fairness, Mike.
These middle management people are incredible, you know?
So what's the bottom line here, Mike? What do we do? Do we just let it close down and let everybody go in the dole and privatise it? Because that's what's going to happen if this continues.
Well, you see, the thing is, all the time, Noel, you've got people, the government of this country, you know. Let me give you an example.
Make it quick. I want to get Paul on before I finish here.
Okay, I will. I'll go then. They keep telling, they keep wanting workers to cut their wages. And what do? They give themselves $5,000 a year.
Okay, well, do me a favour. Stay there for a second, because Paul, very quickly, I've got 3.5 minutes. Go ahead, Paul.
Hi, Noel. You probably remember, like, when you and I were a child, we're both the same age, by the way.
Okay.
We remember very well that, like, even when I was going to school in those, like, 1970s, 80s, Dublin Bus, in Éireann or Éireann, the whole lot of them, they all were striking. And they're still striking to this day over petty nonsense. Because what's going to happen now, come Brexit... The clock will be ticking. They'll still be striking about something else if they get this sorted out. There's always something that comes up. And then, no, we can't do that now. We'll go out and strike. It'll take months to solve it. Mm. And in the meantime, the clock will be ticking down. And everything else, post-Brexit and that, what will happen is that the country will even be pulled down even more. Because they won't have the support of the United Kingdom. Because...
Well, it's going to affect us in many different ways. But okay, Mike believes that anybody who doesn't support the workers obviously has some sort of inherent hatred of the workers.
Well, yeah, no, I don't know. I don't think he does somehow. But...
You don't have a hatred for the workers, do you?
No, I don't. Yeah, Mike
thinks I have a hatred or something. I don't know.
No, I don't think you do. I think.
I don't know them personally.
It's not hatred. It's in ulterior motives.
What's the ulterior motive? I don't even use the bus or the train. So what's the ulterior motive?
Maybe you haven't, but it's just your right wing views.
It's not. You're accusing me of being some sort of capitalist here, which is kind of nonsense. Because the very fact that you're on a mobile phone, you're supporting capitalism anyway.
You're comfortably off. Let's be honest.
I'm not. Hold on for a second. I'm like everybody else. I get a decent wage, Mike. You know, I'm not an RTE. I get a decent wage and I work a lot of hours. I work over 40 hours a week.
You have a reasonable future. But these people are fighting.
But hang on. If they work with the company, they have a reasonable future too. But if they don't, work with the company, they'll have no future. So they've got a choice.
I don't believe in that bull. I don't believe in it. It's bullshit.
What happened to Aer Lingus?
Aer Lingus, yeah.
Went from a staff of 20,000. What have they got now?
Because
all the different sections were all privatised off.
Sure they were, because of a no-nonsense cowboy.
Yeah, because I know my father used to work in Aer Lingus. Half the workers in Aer Lingus were sitting on their arses all day doing nothing at the time. This is back 30, 40 years ago. They were doing nothing.
Better paid than Ryanair workers.
Yeah, and as soon as Ryanair came in, did the cheap flights, Aer Lingus had to buckle up and start getting, you know, doing things properly. And now we've got private bus operators who are running routes and running them profitably. And now you've got, you know, Bus Eireann who can't run the same routes at the same costs. They just can't.
Because the reason for that, Niall, is, and it's a well-known fact, most of the private bus operators' drivers are on social welfare. They're on.
Well, I don't know about that. Now, if you have evidence of that, you should report them.
Well, no, they're on family income supplements.
Oh, family income supplements. Okay, all right. Okay. I thought you meant on the dole.
The
all
whole
right.
country driving buses and to be on family income supplement, then that's.
Well, I don't think Bus Eireann workers are anywhere close to that. All right, but listen, thanks for that, Mike. Loads and loads of people are texting in at 53544. That's 53544. We just want to know your support. Okay, the final tally we had here. 41% of people support the strike, and obviously the rest of you don't. All right? 41% of people supported the strike today. But maybe those people have cars. Text 53544 because we need the bus. I'm sure you wouldn't support it. All right, after the break, I'm going to be looking for more money off you for the Down Syndrome Centre. And also, would you let your kid play violent video games?
The PPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show. Classic hits for FM. PJ Gallagher and Jim McCabe in the morning.
On Friday morning show, we gave poor Dave, our newsreader, a bit of a shock.
A chilly start to the day, but it will be dry with good sunny spells at times, highest temperatures of 9 to 14 degrees in northeast.
Oh my God.
We'll talk to you Monday morning from 6.
Wake up happy!
With Conlon's Land Rover Kildare. They go above and beyond. Conlon'sLandRover.ie on Classic Hits 4FM.
This week at Tesco, find treats to spoil your mum. Get selected Tesco Finest flower bouquets, 2 for €40. Pick up Tesco Finest Prosecco, now only €10. And choose selected Tesco Finest cakes, only €3. It's all part of our promise to stay big on value. Tesco, every little helps. See in store for details. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Let me tell you something, okay? I want to make your home great again, okay? Really great. Just visit Cash Factory. They've got a huge stock of new and pre-loved furniture, and they'll even buy yours for cash, okay? It's fantastic. Beds, office furniture, new mattresses, suites, tables, chairs, and lots, lots more. Might even take a look for myself. I've just moved into a big new house. Join me at Cash Factory Furniture, save a fortune, and make your home great again. Cash Factory. Try them first at Kinsale Road, Cork City, and Tume Road, Galway City, or cashfactory.ie. It's fantastic.
Cavalous of Charleville, come on, get behind the wheel. Cavalous of Charleville, you won't find a better deal.
Our end of quarter clearance on new Fords is now on until the end of March. Save thousands across all models, including over €4,000 on Kuga. Opt for 0% finance on our ST line range, and for these weeks only, avail of 2 years free motor tax on our most popular models. But hurry, offers only valid until the end of March. Call today or visit Cavanaugh.com for more.
Spent ages searching for a better insurance deal lately? One call to First Ireland Insurance will get you our best deal. We'll compare up to 35 products from 20 insurers to find great prices on home and motor insurance for all ages nationwide. Call 1819 323 323 or click firstireland.ie. First Ireland. We price around so you don't have to. First Ireland Risk Management Limited, trading as First Ireland Insurance, is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland.
The Olympia Theatre proudly presents Alison Moyet, The Other Tour. Live at the Olympia on Saturday, October 28th.
You took a whole lot of loving for a handful of nothing.
tickets from £47.05 on sale now. Additional charges may apply in certain circumstances. Alison Moyet, live at the Olympia this October.
It's almost 2 p.m. with Hertz Van Rental. Book it, fill it, move it. HertzVanRental.com.
It's very good afternoon. It's 2 o'clock. This is Classic Hits 4FM. I'm Niall Boylan. And with the latest on the newsroom, here's John Hart.
Thousands of commuters will have to make alternative travel arrangements this evening due to today's Bus Eireann strike, as unions say they understand the frustration of the public, but say they will not end their strike unless pay cuts are reversed. Some Irish Rail services have been affected by the dispute, with some staff refusing to cross pickets. These bus drivers in Waterford say they cannot take the proposed cuts.
Our members probably can't even afford to be on strike. Everybody have mortgages and bills and all that, same as everybody else. We can't accept a race to the bottom. We just can't do it. And that's what the company are looking for.
I can assure the public listening out there, drivers and workers in general don't want to be on strike. But we've been forced to this position because of intransigence by management of Bus Eireann.
A 40-year-old Wicklow man's been found guilty of murdering a woman he cheated on with his wife with. Roy Webster beat Anne Shortall with a hammer on Good Friday 2015 and later hid her body in a workshop adjacent to his home in Ashford. His trial heard they had a one-night stand the previous Christmas, and he claimed he was provoked to attack because she was blackmailing him. He told Gardaí she claimed she was pregnant and was threatening to tell his wife and children if he didn't give her thousands of euros for an abortion. Police in London say at least 50 people were injured in the Westminster terror attack and 31 have required hospital treatment. Michael D. Higgins and Taoiseach Enda Kenny have signed a book of condolence for the victims of the attack. Both also met the British ambassador at the embassy in Dublin. President Higgins says he'll also be writing to the Queen of England.
I think it's very important to see it as the criminal act that it is, affecting citizens and the ordinary business of walking in the public space. I think it's also very important, I think, that any reaction, it doesn't feed into the agenda of those who take such criminal actions.
The efforts to recover the missing crew of helicopter rescue 116 are ongoing. Divers hoping to search the wreckage of the helicopter if conditions remain good off the County Mayo coast. Photojournalist in Blacksaug, Fergus Sweeney, says everyone is determined to find the crewmen.
Amongst the community and amongst all the search and rescue agencies involved, there is great hope, and there was great hope that on discovery of the wreckage of Rescue 116, that, you know, the recovery of the crew would follow shortly on. You know, nothing is for 100% when you deal with these situations. So I guess everybody is kind of hopeful.
The body of an Irish backpacker who was murdered in India has been returned to Ireland. There will now be further tests on Danielle McLaughlin in Dublin after an initial investigation in Goa found she'd suffered brain damage and constriction to the neck. The 28-year-old's body was found on a beach in Canacona 10 days ago.
Have you got a story we should report? Text news to 53544.
For 20 cents.
Entertainment news actor Jake Gyllenhaal says the zero gravity throughout his new movie Life makes it far more scary for audiences. The movie, which is out today, also stars Ryan Reynolds. It tells the story of astronauts being hunted by a deadly Martian creature aboard the International Space Station. Jake Gyllenhaal says it's the only film he can think of which is zero gravity the whole way through.
You never really know what's up and what's down, as, you know, there is none in space. And in basically a horror film and a thriller where you don't know where that next thing is coming, it makes it 4 or 5 times more terrifying.
You're gonna go clockwise from your side. Cat, you're fighting me, Cat. Come on, gotta do it together now. Come on.
Cat.
Look at me.
Cat.
Just pull on the lever, okay? Come on. Just pull down on the lever.
Classic Hits. 4FM Sport is on the way next.
Classic Hits 4FM is the home of the no-repeat 7-7, putting €1,000 on the line.
Terms and conditions apply.
See classichits.ie for more.
Well, sometimes when people ask me what I do, I tell them I spent the last 6 years training to be the very best I can be in my profession. I specialise in interrogating management systems and examining software programmes, and I'm also an expert in thermodynamics and diagnostics.
Owen Manning, Skoda Master Technician.
Skodas have some of the most advanced technologies of any car brand. When I'm not working on Skodas, my passion will be coaching kids in GAA.
Nobody knows your Skoda better than a master technician like Owen. Visit skodaservice.ie to ensure genuine Skoda expertise and great value for money. Skoda, simply clever.
Sport on Classic Hits 4FM.
With Supermax Wholemeal Freshly Grilled Chicken Breast Sandwich with fewer than 350 calories. Now there's a winner.
Tonight's Aviva Stadium sellout could have a major say in Ireland's hopes of ending a 16-year-long wait to play at a World Cup Finals. Ireland League Group D, but away to Wales side featuring Real Madrid star Gareth Bale, who's overcome a long-term ankle injury. The boys in green, meanwhile, are five players short of the same side that started in Vienna, which, of course, they saw the victory over Austria. Manager Martin O'Neill says Ireland are prepared for all possible scenarios.
You can try and cover as many scenarios as possible, and something else will crop up that you thought that, that was a bit strange. But overall, I don't think that there are anything that should surprise us.
It's a 7:45 start. Elsewhere in Group D, Serbia are away to Georgia, Moldova go to Austria. Tottenham Hotspur's Dele Alli has been given a three-match European club ban by UEFA, having sustained a straight red card for a horror tackle against Belgium's Ghent at Wembley Stadium last month. In rugby, Leinster have been hit by a double injury blow. Fullback Rob Kearney's facing 4 weeks out at least after undergoing a procedure on his knee. Fellow veteran Jamie Heaslip will also miss next week's European tie after undergoing a minor procedure on his lower back ahead of the Pro 12 clash with Cardiff tomorrow, with a large number of Irish internationals rested. Munster make five changes for the trip to Zebre. Peter O'Mahony, the standout inclusion. Pat Lam making 10 changes for Connacht's trip to Scotland to take on Glasgow. Tonight, Ulster are away to Dragons from 7:35. And Ireland's cricketers have lost their one-day international series with Afghanistan, beaten by 7 wickets in the deciding match, losing 3-2 overall.
Weather on Classic Hits 4FM with blueinsurance.ie. Are you saving on your home insurance? Could be time to switch. Only at blueinsurance.ie.
Remaining dry this afternoon, plenty of sunny spells. Temperature 9 to 11 degrees in light to moderate winds. 4FM weather with blueinsurance.ie. Saying no to home insurance with your bank, saying yes to big savings only at blueinsurance.ie. That's the latest on Classic Hits 4FM.
Mission 21.
With the Down Syndrome Centre. Help us raise €21,000 in just 5 days on Classic Hits 4FM.
Oh, but like I just mentioned, somebody texted in, he's a bus driver, private bus driver, and he says, I certainly don't get the family income supplement, so please let that lad know who made that claim. I didn't tell him, he said, oh, yes, I'll get it. Tell him to get his facts straight before he can make silly comments. Yeah, some bus drivers, private bus drivers, get good money. Now, here's the situation. 26,000. We're over 26,000 now. We got the 21 grand. That was our mission. We got it yesterday. Wouldn't it be just great? By the end of the day today, this is the last day of Mission 21, raising money for our charity partner, the Down Syndrome Centre, all this week. We're doing our good deed for the year, and you can help us with that deed today. I'm thinking, I know you're thinking, Niall, you're greedy. I am. I'm really greedy. Wouldn't it be just mental? Wouldn't it be just mad, Ted? If we could get it up to 30,000 before the end of the show at 3 o'clock today. It's 26 grand now. We did it yesterday. We got 4,500 in 2 hours yesterday. Wouldn't it be just amazing if we could get it to 30,000? And then maybe Garrick could get a few more thousand. Imagine going to them, say, tomorrow, when we hand over that cheque, it'd be 33, 34,000 euro. Imagine that. It would give so much help to those children. So what I want you to do is, while you're having a quick listen to this interview, and this is Kieran, her 8-year-old daughter, talking about her 8-year-old daughter, Ava. Before you listen to it, I want you to get out your phones. Just do it one more time. This is my last time asking you, by the way. I won't be asking you Monday, I promise. It'll all stop Monday. And you can give to whatever charity you want. But this is my last time asking you, okay? I want to get it up to 30,000 before 3 o'clock. So, take out your phones, text DSC to 50300. That's DSC to 50300. It'll cost you €4. It's a donation. It all goes to the Down Syndrome Centre, unless certain networks do charge VAT, but you won't get charged the VAT. They just lose out a little bit and get 325 instead. Not our fault. So text DSC to 50300. Come on, everybody. Come on, everybody, take out your phones. Gareth, Helena, take out your phones. Yep, I do it. Text DSC to 50300. Or if you want to donate more than that, you can. Just go to the classichits.ie website and click the donate button. And you can do it from there. You can donate as much as you want. If you've got 500 quid spare, like somebody did yesterday at the end of the show, that'd be great. 1,000. Oh, wow. All right, we get up to 30,000 before 3 o'clock. All right, have a quick listen to this. This is Kira talking about her 8-year-old daughter, Ava.
We've always been aware of the charities involved in Down syndrome since Ava was born, and their office used to be quite near us in Dunleary, so we used to do bits and pieces with them from early on. So we were delighted when they actually got to open the centre, because we remember before the centre was even open.
For once in my life, I have someone who needs me, someone I've needed so long.
Ava is 8. She gets wonderful occupational therapy here, for example, and she also did the SCIP program when she was younger. And early intervention is huge with any child with a disability, and if you have access to any of those therapies, it's wonderful. We didn't know until the day she was born, so it was a bit of a shock, and we had no personal experience at all of Down syndrome, so it was quite a dark, scary world to be in at the very first day. And unfortunately, the medical profession weren't much use, to be honest with you. They gave you kind of doomsday scenarios all the time, and we didn't even know that children with Down syndrome were now going to mainstream school, a lot of them, or were thriving and living somewhat independent lives. So, you know, it really makes you worry about people who are getting those diagnoses all the time now, that they're still being told this, you know, and that they need to know that there is hope out there and that it's not all doom and gloom. And that's why I like agreeing to try and support people like Down Syndrome Centre, to get a positive message out there that's not available anywhere else. I feel that the work that we put in now is what will help her in the long term. And also, as we've gotten to know, I mean, there's adults even working here in the centre with Down Syndrome, and it just shows that, you know, they can live an independent life as much as possible. And I suppose, you know, if you woke up every morning worrying about the future, you'd never get anywhere. You know, you just have to take each day as it comes. But we're very encouraged with the progress she's making all the time, and we can see it ourselves. And we would encourage everyone to please help. That's making a difference, and we can see it every day, the difference it's making.
Sorrow hurt me, not like it's hurt me before. For once I have something.
All right, now's your opportunity. Text DSC to 50300. That's DSC to 50300.
Mission 21.
To donate just €4, text DSC to 50300 or click donate on classichits.ie. 100% of your donation goes to the Down Syndrome Centre across most network operators. Some operators apply VAT, which means that a minimum of €3.25 will go to the Down Syndrome Centre. Service provider like charity.
By the way, in relation to the bus strike as well, Dermot O'Leary, who's the NBRU General Secretary, said it's nothing short of scandalous that Bus Eireann would resort to attacking its own staff through cutting their wages to facilitate the Minister and his department into becoming a reincarnation of Pontius Pilate in denying all responsibility for creating the expressway crisis. But the Minister, or should I say, the CEO of Bus Eireann, has clearly said that if we don't do this, we will lose the company. It's gone. And all those people could lose their jobs. So, you know, I mean, nobody's suggesting for a minute what's happening is fair, because there's always going to be unfairness in life. There will be, obviously, layoffs. People will be paid. They've offered, I believe, there's not going to be voluntary redundancies, but there will be redundancies probably at 2.5 weeks per year of service, which is half a week over what the statutory redundancy would be. But I'm asking you, do you support it? Now, a little bit later on too, I'm going to have Jamie on to talk about an app, by the way, that's quite dangerous. And if you are a parent out there, okay, and you're listening today, I advise you to hang on for about 5 or 10 minutes. We're going to be talking to Jamie about an app that a lot of kids are downloading, and it's quite dangerous, and he's set a campaign up at the moment to try and get something done about it. But we'll talk about that in a second. But first, let me go to Dennis. Dennis, you're a Bus Eireann driver. You're currently on strike.
That's correct, no idea.
Okay, and Dennis, to you, why are you on strike personally?
Well, personally, my wages would be slashed by €148 per week, 23%.
Okay, now, when you say that's not your basic wage because you're losing out on overtime?
My board works over 7 weeks, and average I work 42.7 hours per week.
Okay, so you're working 2.7 over, well, what is it, 30, what's the basic, 38, isn't it? It's not actually 40, is it?
It's 39. It's
39, okay. So you're working 3.5 hours overtime, essentially?
Roughly.
So you're going to lose that overtime, possibly?
I'd lose that over time. They want to do away with the rota and shift allowance as well.
And what are the shift allowances? Can you give us some indication of what shift allowances are there?
It makes up a big part of your pay. If we were to just work on the basic, basically be below €400.
So if you work at a certain time, what is it, similar to nurses, if you work after 7 o'clock on a Friday or whatever it is, or those kind of...
Take it yesterday. I started at 4 o'clock yesterday and I booked off at 10 past 1 in the morning. Now, that was Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday. Tomorrow, I'd go on to what's called the Wicklow Run. And I would start at lunchtime tomorrow and I'd book off at 12:30 at night.
So what's the shift? Do you get a shift rate then for the antisocial hours or whatever it is?
Yeah, on some of those runs, yeah.
All right,
So now,
I don't know what sort of money you're on. You don't have to tell me, right, how much you're actually coming out with at the end of each month.
Yeah.
I understand the sacrifices that are going to have to be made by workers, right? And I understand people are going to be on less money because they're losing some of those shifts, they're losing some of those overtime rates, but if they're not losing basic pay. They've offered an increase of between 1% and 3% basic pay. Now, maybe that's not enough. I don't know yet, okay?
Over 4 years, Niall, that's what we've been offered. If the company is in profit, but what I lose is 23%, we're also owed 6%, and plus we have over the years taken two wage reductions to assist the firm. For a company that was in 40 million profit, that money was taken out of Bus Eireann to share between the COE group, all of a sudden we're in debt.
10 million.
There's something
right. And there is something radically wrong.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And it's not working anymore. It just doesn't make money. And Shane Ross has basically said the government just doesn't have the money to keep funding it. So, but the bottom line here, Dennis, is if something isn't done, it's gone. So we got to look at the bigger picture. Now, I know the unions are saying to you, oh, don't worry, lads, everything will be grand. But the unions have been wrong in the past.
Sorry, Niall, the unions are not saying that. The unions have made it quite clear to us this is going to be a long, hard fought battle. And we, the unions, have told us categorically, we don't know where this is going to end up. We are fighting for our lives, Niall. We're fighting
for our
lives.
But are the unions going to be, and I don't mean this in a smart way, but are the unions going to stand in the dole queue with you, Dennis, if this closes down? Yeah, and I would hate to see that happen to anybody.
No, Niall, you know, the way you've put that is, you know, it's totally wrong.
It's not, because the CEO of the company has said that himself. But not about the dole queue, obviously, but he did say already that, you know, if this doesn't work out, that the company's in serious difficulty. And he says it will go out of business. Out of business.
Correct.
That only means one thing.
No, correct.
That means privatisation. That's what that means.
Yeah, but the privates are out there, and the National Transport Authority only the other day issued a licence for a private operator to operate on the Dublin to Belfast. Now, there's operators already on that road. They are flooding the market with private buses.
That's and the problem.
Basically, myself and the lads have been talking, and we have said this is their way of picking us off.
But if you go back to the days of what was it called? Unpust, when they used to look after the telephone service in this country, they had a monopoly, right? Yeah. So they could charge what they pretty much wanted. Yeah. And when mobile phones came in, you only had two operators at the start, Vodafone and Digicel or whatever the hell it was, right?
Yeah.
And everybody was paying ridiculous mobile phone bills. And all of a sudden, you have more coming onto the market. And the more that comes onto the market, the cheaper the product has to be, the more efficiently it has to run.
Yeah.
That's
the
way it works. And unfortunately, the Irish bus service and rail service has been dominated and obviously had a monopoly for years. The rail service still does, obviously. But the bus service had a monopoly for years and years with CIE.
Yeah.
But mind you, we did cut routes. When I was a kid, I was on the 28, used to go to Edenmore. They got rid of that and everybody had to get the 42. So they did cut routes years ago. But now we're in a situation where there's private bus operators who are willing to run the busy routes. And, CIE, or Bus Eireann, should I say, now have to be more affordable. It just has to run better. And they're not doing it.
We are willing, and it has been stated in the media, Niall, by Air Union, that we are willing to sit down and discuss efficiency. Mr. Herman wants to introduce this immediately.
That's right.
Now, you talk about other competitors on the road. I understand that. I know some of the drivers. Some of my duties are out the airport.
And they wouldn't be getting some of the stuff that you're getting.
Well, one of your commentators, I only come in at the last minute, but one of your commentators, the majority of private operators who have drivers on their books are operating illegally, that they will be claiming the dole and they'll be getting that.
Illegally?
Well, they're walking and they're getting the dole.
But if you know somebody who's doing that, I mean, don't get me wrong, I'd hate to think that. If you know somebody's doing that, you should report them.
Well, we have reported. We know what's going on, Niall. We walk into the industry.
Okay, but look at what he's talking about, okay? So he says basically in future sick benefits will be...
Dublin Airport, and they are terrified to try and form a union in their own company.
But a lot of companies won't accept unions. Yeah, I know that. I understand that. Okay, but look what he says here. In future, sick benefits will be calculated on basic pay. Normally, sick benefits in most companies are calculated on basic pay. That's normally the way it works.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it shouldn't be calculated on overtime and shift rates anyway. Staff will have to accept redeployment and what he calls reasonable changes to roles and responsibilities. So in other words, everybody kind of has to pull together a bit and do a few things maybe they didn't have to do before. Is that unreasonable?
Other roles within the company, okay? I'm a driver. I'm at the company and I have to be on a 12-hour shift, Niall. Do you think it's reasonable for me to get out then and start cleaning the inside of the bus, cleaning the outside of the bus, refueling that bus and have it ready for the next driver who may be operating at 4 o'clock in the morning? Do you think that's reasonable?
When you see, now this is the kind of whole nurse argument, when you start talking about a 12-hour shift and nurses go, oh, well, I'll do 12 hours, yeah, but you didn't tell us that you got 4 days off afterwards, you know what I mean?
Okay. Yeah.
So you're still only doing the same amount of hours. But if you finished 2 hours earlier and they said, look, we wouldn't mind if you refueled the bus for us or, you know, brought it down to the wash, whatever it is you bring the bus down to, I mean, all those things have to be done, you know, because that might save a job somewhere. I could understand them wanting to do that.
It'd be getting rid of jobs.
But absolutely. But hold on, but that's the point, isn't it? But hang on, but there's nothing you can do about that, Dennis. There is jobs going to be lost. That's the bottom line. I don't want to see people lose their jobs, but unfortunately, you're working for a company who can't make money.
On the PSOs, Niall, that company is making money. How did this company go from making 40 million down to working at a loss?
Because the money is not being spent. Well, like the HSE, we've bad administration, yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to speak on behalf of...
You've also got the Swift routes out there as well, which I believe are losing their you-know-whaties. The expressways and Swift routes.
Hey, Niall, I'll give you the Galway run as an example. That it leaves Bus Eireann and heads out to the airport, Maynooth, it makes its way down into Athlone, and it does all the Rochford Bridge, Kilbeggan's, Tyrrell's Pass, into Moat, Ballinasloe, Rosscrea, where the private operator has been given a licence, leaves Dublin and goes straight to Galway. If you want to go to Galway, Niall, what bus are you going to get on? You're not going to get on the Bus Eireann. And when Bus Eireann asks for the licence to operate expressways, no. So, there's obviously somebody there in the background, whether it's the government, Shane Ross, the NTA, want to wind up the Bus Eireann company. And basically what I want to tell to your listeners is there will be 2,600 people going on the dole. It won't only affect the 2,600, it'll have a knock-on effect then to their families, their kids who want to go on to third level education, their mortgages, their way of life.
And Dennis, you're on strike obviously since last night.
But who's going to pay for all that, Niall?
I mean, how long do you think the strike is going to last?
Well, we are contributing at the moment to the state funds.
How long do you think the strike is going to last, Dennis?
Well, we're going to, it's out indefinitely. And the ones, and I'm going to say this, and I've no fear of saying this, Niall, is the people that are feared most in Bus Eireann is the management, as what we call the big house. Because I guarantee you, if this place folds, they wouldn't get a job in the private industry.
Listen, Dennis, thanks very much indeed. And Dennis, on a personal level, I don't want to see anybody lose their job or anybody losing too much money or anything like that. But I do understand partly what management are saying. I think they're going about it the wrong way. I'll give you that. All right, listen, Dennis, thanks, and I wish you luck, all right? Let me go to Jamie. Jamie, you're on Classic Hits.
Good afternoon, Owen. How are
Jamie,
you?
Jamie, a word of warning to parents out there, particularly of, I suppose, younger teenage children. What age group is this simi marketing towards?
We're hearing reports from, and I put it out on Facebook yesterday, it's going to get a feeler. We're looking at reports from like 12 upwards.
Okay, and the name of this app is called SIMI, Simi. Is it Simi?
SimSimi. So SIMSIMI.
Oh, SimSimi. All right, okay.
And what it is, it's like Ask FM, but it's a lot more accessible.
Now, to remind people about Ask FM was something that we talked a lot about 2 or 3 years ago, because many teenagers took their own lives because of Ask FM.
Ask FM was directly linked to 14 suicides in Ireland at the time of its release.
And the reason being these teenagers were being bullied anonymously on Ask FM.
And that's what it is. It's totally anonymous. There's no traceability. Whereas Ask FM, there was a small amount of traceability with IP addresses and stuff like that. But now SimSimi has gone through the App Store with Apple and it's untraceable basically.
So it's running what they call a proxy server, which basically means you can't trace it.
That's exactly what's happening. And
so I can go on there, set up an account, nobody knows who I am.
You don't even need to set up an account.
And I can start abusing you.
You don't even need to set up an account. It's totally anonymous.
So anybody can just go on and start tapping away. And how did Apple even allow this? Because Apple are quite strict.
So what happens is, it's an app. So say I type in Niall Boylan.
Yep.
It'll hit back with me then with a comment that someone else has left about Niall Boylan. Now it could be a negative or a positive. So I've got some positives and I've got some negatives. So it could be Niall Boylan is a great radio host. Or one of the comments back could be Niall Boylan is an awful radio host.
Mm.
And people input answers into the system for... So I can put in Niall Boylan and put the answer I want in to me to get back.
And is anybody monitoring it? If you put up like Niall Boylan is fat or he's small or he's whatever.
There's no monitoring system. There's no reporting system. So there's only one thing you can do, which is press the bell. And when you press the bell, you flag this as a comment. But I pressed the bell on one of mine 4 days ago and it's still there.
Still there.
So like, to give you an example of some of the stuff I've got is, he saves me, thank very much, or then he should have jumped in the lippy with your man after him. So there's some fairly graphic stuff.
Okay, so children can download this. There's obviously no age restriction.
No.
The majority of people using it seem to be teenagers?
Yeah, it's all teenagers. It's all kind of 12 and up.
So what steps are you taking? Are you trying to get this stopped? So what steps are you taking?
So we're petitioning Facebook, Twitter and the App Store, because at the moment you can directly go to Simi's Facebook page,
yep,
type in a name through Messenger and it'll bounce back the comments through Messenger, so you don't even have to download the app.
Okay.
So if you have Facebook open there now, you can type in Simi and message him and type in my name and you can see what kind of comes up. And that'll give you an example of some of the stuff.
Yeah, Helena's doing it there now at the moment. All right, so somebody just texted in, what's the name of the app again? It's called SimSimi. So you hear a child even mention the word SimSimi, just take a good look.
And it's what it's doing now is the app creators have realised that they're in a bit of trouble. So they've changed the picture from the app place, from the store, the Apple store. So it used to be the logo, it's now a yellow balloon.
Right, okay.
With SimSimi inside it. So the creators know that this app is being blasted online.
Right, okay. Well, look, it's a great... Listen, Jamie, I appreciate that. Thanks very much. I know you're going to do sterling work to try and get it sorted out or try and get something happening.
Well, we've called on Facebook now. We've called on Facebook to meet us, and their online safety team have said they'll meet us in the next couple of days.
Okay.
But we're now saying to Facebook safety team, we have another couple of days. We need to meet Monday morning, 9 a.m, with Twitter and with Apple. It's very hard to get hold of an Apple representative in Ireland, but Twitter's...
That's quite ironic, considering Ireland is their head office, really, isn't it?
Yeah. Twitter's online safety team have been amazingly helpful. They put a block on their on SimSimi's account. Now, I think it's been lifted since, but they put a block on it for an hour or two this morning while they investigated it. But the way SimSimi is getting away with it is, what people are getting positive comments too.
The word of warning for teenagers is, unfortunately, it is anonymous. People can make personal comments about each other, and this is enough to drive people to do silly things, unfortunately. And we've seen this before in the past. Jamie, listen, I appreciate it, all right? The name of the app, by the way, for anybody interested, is SimSimi. And you heard Jamie saying it's a yellow balloon, so if you see it on your child's phone, you know, inquire, find out exactly what they're doing with it. Probably not such a good idea. This is the last thing you want on your child's phone. It's called SimSimi, and you can get it through Facebook and Twitter as well at the moment. Well, Twitter did block it this morning, and Jamie, obviously, very proactive, trying to get it banned through Facebook as well. Fair play to him. He's a good kid. He looks after the kids very well. Okay, keep texting 53544. After the break, I'm going to be asking you, is it okay for a child to be playing violent video games? I got an interesting email here. I'll just read it out very quickly before we get to the break. I listened to your show every day and honestly never thought I would email you until now. I want to discuss something for me. My 8-year-old son had his friends over on Saturday afternoon and they're up in his room playing games. I love hearing all the kids having fun because I believe as a parent it's important to know who your friends or the kids' friends are playing with. His two friends are lovely and they've been mates for a couple of years now. One of them is a little tearaway, but boys will be boys, I suppose. The thing is, and the one thing I can't understand though, is the other parents not giving a hoot about their children and what they're up to. On Saturday I went upstairs to the boys to ask them if they wanted something to eat and I saw them playing this disgusting violent game on the PlayStation. I walked in and my son was shooting a prostitute in the game. I lost my rag, switched off the game, my son got really angry and I told his friend to go home and to bring their game with them. I had no, obviously this other kid brought the game around with him. I had no idea they were playing this game as I would never allow it for my own son. I went over to the boy's parents and said that I didn't think the game was suitable for a child. She basically told me that it was only a game and the boys understood that and that's that. I should lighten up a little bit. Safe to say, I told my son he is not to play with this particular boy anymore. I told my husband all about it, and while he agrees with me that our son shouldn't be playing the games like this, he thinks I'm overreacting a little bit. That's why I'm emailing you. I would like to hear a listener's opinion on this. Do your listeners think it's irresponsible to allow young children to play violent video games? I personally do, and I believe I'm right and not to let my son play these games or hang around with this kid anymore. Now, I'm pretty sure the game she's talking about was Grand Theft Auto, because you do get to shoot prostitutes in Grand Theft Auto. So I'm pretty sure that's the game she's talking about. Tens of thousands of people and kids are playing these games on a regular basis. Many parents don't see any harm in it and rubbish the claims that the games make kids violent in any shape or form. On the other hand, there are, and there have been, multiple high-profile cases where mass and sadistic killers have played these sorts of games online. Now, we all know these games are over 18s for a reason, yet many parents still allow their children to play them. And many parents let their kids play Grand Theft Auto. It's an over-18s game. And I know kids as young as 8 or 9 years of age who got it for Christmas. Now, you wouldn't buy, I don't know, you wouldn't buy a porn movie for your child for Christmas, would you? Or Kill Bill, the movie, the Quentin Tarantino movie. Clearly over 18s, it's violent. You wouldn't buy that for your child. You wouldn't even subject them to watching it. But yet you let them do it to a video game. Is it irresponsible parenting to allow your child to play games, these violent video games, or certainly games that are not rated for them? Is that irresponsible, even though everybody does it? Is it irresponsible, or is it just a game? Let us know what you think. 53544. That's 53544. Somebody says, hi, Niall. I just got into Sim Simi. No bother. Yellow balloon. My child is going through these terrible teens. He doesn't need this, says Elizabeth. Oh, what? You just found it on his phone.
Have you got an opinion?
What's on your mind?
Call 1850-410-494. Niall Boylan. Real Talk Radio.
Classic Hits 4FM.
Gareth O'Callaghan in the afternoon.
Well, when it comes to Classic Hits, Friday's set list looks like an absolute list of gems. Join me at 3 o'clock on Friday during the show. One lucky Leaving Cert or Junior Cert student is going to win an Easter revision course package. It includes five courses from Julie Kilmartin's five-star revision courses in Ennis and Limerick. Just for Laughs is worth €290, and it's day five of Mission 21 in aid of the Down Syndrome Centre. How high can we go? Join me Friday at 3 to find out.
With the Tesco Community Fund, over €2 million donated to local causes chosen by you.
Classic Hits
4FM.
Under the thumb, under the bed, under pressure, under illusions, under suspicion, or under arrest. If you're under any of these, we can't help. But if you're under the weather, well, that's a different story. At undertheweather.ie, you'll get sensible, practical advice from GPs and pharmacists about common illnesses like colds, flu, sore throats, rashes and tummy bugs. Visit undertheweather.ie and find out how to treat common complaints with common sense. Get advice and get better. Brought to you by the HSE.
It's spring clear-out time at the Furniture Liquidator with amazing deals throughout the store. Guaranteed Irish sofas half price from $599. Three-drawer ivory lockers, €50. Four deep-drawer ivory chests, €150. Headboards half price from €35. Solid oak three-table nest, $199. Gas lift stools from €25. And solid French oak dining tables from $199. All stock available to take away or next-day delivery. Don't miss the spring clear-out at the Furniture Liquidator. Find us at Gulliver's Retail Park, Santry, Beacon, South Quarter, Sandyford and Bruce Avenue, Stillorgan.
Picture an unspoilt view across Dingle Bay, along with an array of activities and sightseeing all within easy reach. The Dingle Skellig Hotel is a breathtaking retreat, and a visit will leave you planning your next one. With a leisure club, creche, kids club and spa, their selection of getaway breaks has something for everyone. Visit dingleskellig.com.
It's bonus time for Electric Ireland Rewards members, which means even bigger savings on your Electric Ireland bills. Until April 30th, 250 SuperValue Real Rewards points will save you €5 on your energy bills. Get extra savings with your shopping. Visit electricirelandrewards.ie. Electric Ireland. Smarter living. Terms and conditions apply.
The Olympia Theatre proudly presents Paul Carrick in a fully seated headline performance on the 18th of October.
Satisfy my soul.
Tickets €36 on sale now. Additional charges may apply in certain circumstances.
Take it to a stream. There must have been an angel.
Paul Carrick, live at the Olympia this October. Believe it or not, there are now even more reasons to love the fabulous SEAT Ibiza. With our best ever offers, the Ibiza is even more affordable than ever before. Because at Monaghan & Sons, with up to €3,000 scrappage and our lowest ever monthly repayments, you can drive away in a brand new SEAT Ibiza for far less than you might imagine. And on top of all that, we'll give you a 3-year service plan for just €299. Order today and look forward to getting on the road in your new 171 SEAT Ibiza. Visit Monaghan & Sons, Tuam Road, Galway.
Thinking of installing a new alarm or upgrading your old one? Install a DJ Royale wireless monitored alarm system to protect your home and family. With live camera streaming and control room monitoring, along with our app, you will be in total control, all for just €650. For total peace of mind and total control, visit djroyale.ie.
At M&S this weekend, you can dine in with us for just €14. Choose a delicious main course with sides for two, a dessert for two, and a bottle of wine from a selection of products, all for just €14. Only M&S. Selected products in stores subject to availability. Enjoy wine responsibly. Offer runs Wednesday to Tuesday.
The BPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show. Classic hits
for All right, keep texting 53504. There's nothing wrong with the games, Niall. My 8-year-old plays Grand Theft Auto, sees nothing wrong with it. He knows it's only a game. He realises it's not real life. Get your kids a golf game. Bart Simpson loves something or other. So this is Niall. No, Matt, what so-called scientists say, violent games and TV programmes do desensitise children to violent behaviour. We need to tackle and censor these games and programmes before it's too late, if it's not already. No, I don't agree with you. We don't censor the games, and we don't do anything with the games. The games are perfectly fine. It's not the games that's the problem, it's the parents. Keep texting 53504. There's nothing wrong with violent video games, if you're an adult. Peter, go ahead.
How's it going now? You well?
Good. Do you believe it's irresponsible parenting?
Well, I wouldn't let now, as I was telling your research, I have 3 young lads now, and they play games and that. And just over the last 2 years now, I've cut down on their game time and all that. They all play football, sports, basketball, and stuff like that. Even on wet days or over weekends, I tell them, you're only allowed to play that game for so long. And I don't agree. My sister had one of them games 2 years ago, and the language, and I told her, and she went in and put the game on, and she brought the game back to the store.
And what age was the kid she bought it for?
12.
But see, now, if there's language in the game, it would have over 15s or PG.
Oh, yeah, and 18, yeah.
Yeah, so or 18.
If other parents want to do that and they think there's nothing wrong with the games,
But when you say that your sister bought it, and I'm having a go with your sister, but when she bought it, surely she realised it was going to be bad language when it has an 18 cert written clearly on the front of it.
Yeah, well, she didn't think it was as bad as what people were telling her until I said, you'd want to stick on that game and see how bad it is.
I mean, I know Grand Theft Auto and I know Call of Duty and all these other games. And, you know, with Grand Theft Auto, literally, you can go to a lap dancing club and there's naked women in it. You can shoot prostitutes. You can hire a prostitute. I mean, now, that's all well and good if you're over 18 years of age and you want to play that type of game.
Well, I'll put you this way, Niall. About a year and a half ago, a year ago, I was refereeing a game. And what a young lad said to another young lad on the field of play to him was something from that I had heard on the Grand Theft Auto. Now, didn't get it from anywhere else.
Well, don't repeat
that's
it in the middle of the day anyway.
Playing the game.
I can only imagine. I can only imagine.
And it was bad. And then they wanted to know, why was he sent off with a red card? I said, well, whether he heard that or I was saying to my old dad, you can't talk to a player like that, for starters. End of story.
Yeah, I mean, they've got quite strict in what you can and can't say on a football pitch now, compared to the old days. How long are you refereeing, Peter?
I'll put it this way. I played inter-county football and senior football from when I was 16. I'm 5 years refereeing now, and I'm telling you here now, if you think it's getting any better out there, you're sadly mistaken.
All right, well, stay there for a second, because Tony, you're on Classic Kids. How are you doing, Tony?
How are you, Niall?
Tony, you think it's okay if the parent plays the game with the child?
Yeah, a bit of education maybe, because they're going to go behind their backs and play it, aren't they?
So if you got Grand Theft Auto, for example, and we're using that as the example because it is considered to be the most common, well, it's the biggest selling game of all time. So you got that game, and if little Johnny, he's 11 years of age, is sitting beside you, and you say to him, okay, now remember, this is only a game, this is not a real gun. Is that okay?
Yeah. Well, you educate him in the game, you know?
Educate him.
But Yeah, educate him and play with him and let him realise that that's his only game.
And do you think he gets? Do you think he gets a grip of that? Do you think he understands that? That when he's putting a machine gun to somebody's head and blowing their head off, you think he understands that? That it's not.
Yeah, right? Tell him it's a bit of fun. That's all it is. Like
a bit of fun.
But okay. But I would think, Niall, I think the government should ban all iPhones to under 16s.
Well, that would be impossible to monitor. Because
but they'd be up to the parents then.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You'd have to get parents. Well, I would imagine under 16 years of age, parents buy them for them anyway.
Well, that'll never happen.
Parents get the phones for them anyway. But I say, if the government put a ban in on iPhones, because that's where all the trouble has come from. iPhones, you can get games on iPhones as well. You can get Grand Theft Auto on iPhones.
But the Grand Theft Auto on an iPhone is certainly not as violent as the one you get on a PlayStation.
Well, if it's the same. But if a government put a ban on iPhones.
But hang on, Tony, you just told me it's okay to let them play the game as long as you're with them.
But see, you're with them, you're not with them on an iPhone.
What difference does it make if you... Would you sit down and watch a porn movie with your 11-year-old?
No.
But well, then why would you sit down and watch a violent video game?
I actually don't think in my life I ever watched porn.
Sorry? Say it again?
I actually don't think in my life I ever watched it.
Go away out of that.
I haven't time, Niall.
What, Tony, we're all lads here,
I haven't. I haven't time.
Sheepers, creepers.
I haven't time.
Peter, have you watched a porn?
Yeah.
Yeah, Tony, I did too. Come on, Tony. Man up there, will you? Man up, for God's sake. Just admit it. We're all lads here. There's only the three of us. Nobody else will hear it.
Tony,
see, I'm with you on everything else that you said. Well, apart from the porn thing. I'm with you on everything else you said, apart from... I don't understand what your logic in saying it. So why not just say to him, no, you can't play it?
Because they play. Listen, Niall, you tell some young fella he can't do something, and don't you worry, he's going to do what you tell him the opposite. And I notice it's all his boys are playing this kind of stuff.
I know there's girls playing them too. No, not as many, I think, but there are girls playing them too.
Very little, but they're going to do it anyway, Niall. It doesn't matter what you're going to say.
Somebody texts in and says, how can Tony call playing violent video games with your kids educational? Where's the education in this?
You're educating him on that's his only game.
What?
But the language, there's the language in the game as well.
There is language in the game, yeah.
Yeah, and with Grand Theft Auto, there's racist language.
Yeah.
You know, there's like, kill that effing cop and all this kind of thing. And
It's like you know, kids nowadays at 15, 16, they're going to do things behind your back that you don't want them to do. And if you're with them, you're better off.
But that argument holds no water because, say, for example, you know, the kid might try to have a cigarette at 15, right? Okay,
yeah.
Or you might try and have a bottle of beer at 15 behind your back, right?
Because
kids will be kids, right?
Yeah.
But you don't do it. You don't let him do it in front of you. You don't encourage him to do it. You're hoping he doesn't do it. Yeah, sorry, Tony. Oh, Peter, go ahead.
But sir, whether you let them do the game, there's enough in schools or out the bus or on the bus or playing games or listening to their mate or other stuff, they're going to hear it without having watching on the game as well.
Yeah.
That's not how they care. They know all about that anyway.
Yeah, but if you're with them, you can educate them. You can be there with them, playing the games, be with them.
And how old is your little fella, Tony?
I don't have any boy.
Oh, okay.
I'm all girls.
Oh, you're all girls, okay. Do I even play PlayStation?
All girls.
I ain't gonna play the PlayStations. No,
she doesn't play nothing like that. She all educating, but that's all she does. School.
Okay, but you don't see any issue with say little 11-year-old Johnny playing Grand Theft Auto.
I don't have any, but I would play with him if I had a little Johnny.
Anita, you're on Classic Kids. Go ahead, Anita.
Hiya, how are you doing?
Okay, Tony hasn't got a little Johnny, by the way. He just wanted to remind us all, and he's never watched porn. So, Anita, you let your children play appropriate games.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, my kids are 10 and 6, and I let them play Minecraft and Pokemon Go
Minecraft is huge.
Things like that.
Yeah.
I mean, those are all appropriate games, and they all have, they do have some kind of, not violence, but even in Minecraft, if you want to eat in the game to survive, you have to go and kill a cow.
Yeah, well, that's
so
okay.
So even in a simple game like that, there is some sort of... The problem is when it's real-like and it's human-like and there's blood and guts and...
And it's gratuitous killing, yeah.
Yeah, and it is, and that's what it's doing, and there's no point to it. Like, at least in Minecraft, it's teaching them, this is how we survive, and it actually teaches them about life.
Yeah.
You know, where does our steak sitting on our dinner plate come from? Well, it comes
from...
Well,
what Tony said, it's all right for you to sit down with your little boy as long as you're sitting beside him while he's doing it. So he can play Grand Theft Auto and listen to all the bad language and shoot the prostitutes and all that kind of stuff as long as you're sitting there beside him.
It does nothing. It was only reinforcing that is okay. It's actually almost worse that you're sitting next to your kid reinforcing that what you're seeing on a TV screen is okay.
Because, Tony, whether it's real life or pretend... Well, hang on, Tony, with the greatest respect. Whether it's real life or pretend, there's nothing right about shooting a prostitute.
Exactly. And
do you know what I mean?
Like, you know, it's just crazy that an 11-year-old should see that. Like,
yeah, go ahead, Tony.
Do you not realise that young fella of yours, he'd probably been somewhere in your friend's house playing the game without you being there and taking it all in a different way?
But again, there's nothing you can do. You can't control that situation, but you can control what goes on in your own home.
I can control it, but you sometimes you're kind of wasting time trying to control it because it actually gets worse.
Well, then you might as well just give up as a parent.
Well,
if you think you're wasting your time.
What I'm saying is you bring them in and put the game on.
I mean, these games are over 18 for a reason.
And
you wouldn't bring home like the movie Kill Bill, the Quentin Tarantino movie. You wouldn't bring it home and say to him, why don't we sit down and watch this and I'll watch it with you. No, of course you wouldn't, because it's over 18. So the manufacturer's put an over 18 cert on it.
As bad as a Kill Bill movie. They're like that.
Yeah.
If you wouldn't let your kids watch a movie like that, why would you let them play a video game?
Okay, well, do me a favour. Stay there, both of you, for a second, because I'm going to go to Liz as well after the break. Keep texting 53544. Liz should be good for a laugh. Will you let your child play violent video games? Is it okay? Is that irresponsible parenting, or is it just all right?
This is the Niall Boylan Show. Time to join in the conversation online or on your smartphone. Real Talk Radio. Classic Hits 4FM. Okay. Hands up. We messed up. And in case you missed it, here's what happened.
Hello, Emma O'Loughlin, please.
Yeah?
You made a comment on a song that was played.
Looking back over my shoulder.
Yeah, it was played at 8:49 this morning, which means...
Oh, my God.
You have just won yourself 1,000 euros.
€1,000 in cash, just as we promised. The home of the no repeat 7 to 7. And remember, if we mess up, we pay up.
Oh my God, you just made my day, Dad.
Classic Hits 4FM.
She'll say you shouldn't have gone to any trouble, but your mum loves feeling special on Mother's Day. And because you shouldn't be spending your money, Eason have amazing wow prices on lots of the latest bestsellers from authors like Patricia Scanlon, Sinead Moriarty, and many more, along with the biggest range of cards to help find the perfect way to make Mother's Day special without going to too much fuss. Eason, be inspired.
Is that? Oh God, it's your one from Connor's party. Did we? Pretty sure, yeah, we did. What's her name? Pink Man, Pink. Mandy, Sandy, Helga. Oh, it's definitely not Helga. She's coming straight for me.
Oh God, there's your man from Connor's birthday. Did we? I'm not sure. Yeah, we totally did. Come on, what's his name? Why do you always score such weirdos, Helga? Quick, fake a call.
Life's complicated. Choosing the right network isn't. Switch to Tesco Mobile, Ireland's most recommended network. Tesco Mobile, we hear you.
It's that time of year, and Barry and Julie are not thinking about Bord Gáis Energy.
Hibernation is great.
It's not like going out as an option.
And we're on. Switch to Bord Gáis Energy and get €150 back off your bill, plus 12% off electricity and 10% off gas.
€150? We're going out.
It helps if it's Bord Gáis Energy. Call 01611 0111 or visit boardgoshenergy.ie. Dual fuel contract only. Discount is on our standard unit rates for 12 months with level pay and paperless billing. See boardgoshenergy.ie for full T's and C's.
Now ready for spring. Tobermore Paving and Walling Centres in Dublin and Cork have everything you need to create your dream patio or driveway. We offer a wide range of paving bricks, paving flags and walling to suit all budgets and the expert advice needed to get you started. Also, our landscape design services can transform your home into a unique, distinctive paradise. And with countrywide delivery throughout Ireland, what's stopping you? Call in to the Tobermore Paving and Walling Centres in Dublin and Cork or visit tobermore.ie. Tobermore. Quality like no other. J.K. Rowling invites you back to the wizarding world before Harry Potter.
First trip to New York?
Yes.
Where a Newt Scamander arrived with a suitcase of magical beasts and changed the course of magic in America forever.
Why should I help you instead of turning you in?
Fantastic Beasts and Where to Find Them. To own on DVD and Blu-ray from March 24th at Super Value. See in store for details.
Cavernous of Charleville, come on, get behind the wheel. Cavernous of Charleville, you won't find a better deal.
Our end of quarter clearance on new Fords is now on until the end of March. Save thousands across all models, including over €4,000 on Kuga. Opt for 0% finance on our ST line range, and for these weeks only, avail of 2 years free motor tax on our most popular models. But hurry, offers only valid until the end of March.
Cavernous of Charleville.
Call today or visit cavernous.com for more.
stunning sea views, opulent surroundings and gorgeous food. The Gary Vaux Hotel is the perfect choice for your breakaway from the everyday. From €135 per person, you can enjoy a two-night experience, beautiful breakfast and mouth-watering evening meal. Whatever the weather, you couldn't get better than a luxury escape at the Gary Vaux in East Cork. Book now at garyvauxhotel.com. Quote 4FM and receive a complimentary bottle of bubbly.
This week at Centra, we have great offers like Centra Fresh Art Pork Loin Roast, now half price. Spoil your mum this Mother's Day with Griffon Prosecco Frizzante, now €9. Cadbury Roses Carton and Nestle Quality Street Bag, both half price. And Thursday to Sunday only, Lion's Tea 80 pack, also half price. Centra, live every day. Enjoy our call sensibly.
The PPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show.
Well, I keep texting 53544. Some of the texts coming in at the moment. Not, I don't believe Tony's never watched a porn movie. Tony, have you even looked at page 3 of the Sun?
Would you believe, Niall? I done a page 3 survey in school once.
Did you? So you had to look at it for research purposes?
Yeah, we had to do for summer. What you do, you do research on your summer holidays or something. I did the page 3.
Okay. All right, very good. You're very good. Clever. Liz, you're on Classic Hits. Liz, how you doing?
Hiya, Niall.
There you go. You heard Tony. As long as the parent is with them, it's you know, it can be educational.
Yeah, well, I would imagine like porn would probably do more damage, Niall, when you think about it, really, because they really think this shit is going to happen for them. Do you know what I mean?
Porn?
I mean, if they're watching that, they're thinking, well, that's exactly what they're going to get now when they turn 16 and get their jollies off. But when they turn 16, they know these young girls put a bullet in someone's head. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I would imagine porn is probably more damaging to a child than... Now, when I'm talking about 14 and 15-year-olds, I mean, we're talking about 7 and 8, 9, 10...
Well, your young fella is... How old is he now? 15?
Nearly 15, yeah.
Yeah, and does he play games?
Yeah, he does, yeah.
Has he got GTA?
He has.
See, now, here's the thing. GTA is an over-18s game. You knew that.
I know.
You knew that, didn't you?
I did, of course I did. Yeah.
Okay, and when did you buy it for him?
He also knows that he's not have to go outside before bullying someone's head, Niall. He knows that. He's not stupid. He knows.
Yeah, but you bought it for him when it came out, which was nearly 2 years ago.
Yeah, but he still knows.
Yeah, he was 13.
Like, he would have known, Niall. He's a sensible lad. Like, he knows.
Yeah,
but
would you let him watch porn?
Yeah, but I'm sure he's doing it anyway, Niall.
But so, probably is, yeah. Probably
no,
is.
He is. Like, he's 15, so I'm sure he is. Like,
okay, but in the game, you can pick up a lap dancer.
And I'm sure he's out there picking up loads of them in GTA, if that's what he could do, absolutely. But now, look, this is life. Life is life, do you know what I mean? I mean, I'm sure, like, if you're a decent parent and you explain to your kids right from wrong, they know, Niall. They know you're not allowed to go outside and put a bullet in someone's head. They know you don't go along and start shooting prostitutes on the side of the road. They know these things, but not that
much. I'm not suggesting for a minute that some kid is going to run out with a gun and shoot a prostitute or pick up a lap dance for 15 years.
What do you think is going to happen to them? They're going to be scarred for life and tortured. Their soul is going
to be... I think it desensitizes them somewhat. They just think there's nothing... They might see a story on the news that night about a prostitute that has been killed, and they don't think anything of it. They become desensitized. In GTA, the idea is you smash the window, pull a person out of a car, throw them on the road, then run over them.
But
that's what you do in GTA.
You're lacking in your parenting skills. Do you know what I mean? My child knows that what he's with, that's all made up. Do you know what I mean? He also knows right from wrong. He knows that if he even tried to pull someone out of a car, I'd kill him.
Yeah, but absolutely, and he knows there's been right and wrong, and you're saying that's fine. Once he knows the difference, that's all that matters. But you still wouldn't let him watch a violent movie, would you?
I probably would, yeah. Like, I mean, what kind of movie are you talking about?
Well, one of the Quentin Tarantino movies are pretty violent. Any one of those, you can take your pick.
I don't know what they are. I probably didn't watch them myself.
With Pulp Fiction, Reservoir Dogs, Kill Bill.
He's watched, like, all these war movies and all that, where their heads are blown off and all that kind of business.
He's 15 now, so it's not too bad, but when he was young...
I would have watched that about 14 or something like that, yeah?
Would you?
Yeah.
You don't see anything wrong with that, Liz, no?
Well, no, because life is...
I'm not doubting your parents' skills.
Life is life, Niall, and these things happen in life, right?
And I accept that, and when he's older, we have to teach him that, but, maybe 13 is a bit young. I don't know.
At that age, Niall, they're asking questions, and they want to know these things, and it's your responsibility as a parent to sit them down and teach them right from wrong, do you know what I mean? As that fella said there,
Tony.
I mean, you put porn...
Tony, who never watched porn.
Kids are going in. Yeah, well, don't mind Tony. Kids are going in, but I don't believe a word of it.
No.
Kids are going in, watching porn, no. Right? Now, listen, when you hear this, I'll tell you something like that. I told you about that my son, that I found them so much because I found it because I went through his phone when he was about 11 or something, right? And it was two girls in a couple. Now, I'm not going to go into the...
No, don't go into it in the middle of the day. No. I know the one you're talking about.
But I told you about it before, Niall, and I'm telling
it's
you...
It's vile.
That, absolutely disgusting. This was the most inhumane thing you'd ever watched.
I know it. I'm aware of it. Everybody is aware of it, yes.
Would even be tortured by watching this, do you know what I mean?
And your kid watched that.
And he seen, and I asked him, how did he see it? And he said, one of his friends told him to look it up the school, right? And I had to sit down and explain to him that this is not normal behaviour. People do not do that. These girls are off their head. There's something wrong with their wires. It's not normal, do you know what I mean? And I had to go and explain that to my 12-year-old child at the time, do you know what I mean? But these are things that I would worry about more so than him playing the game. With
do, you believe, do you believe that Tony's never watched porn, by the way?
No, I don't believe it. And I've come in and said, you could also say kids going around years ago with these little guns and all shooting at each other and all this business. That would
she never stops talking. She never stops talking. She just keeps going on.
I don't believe a word of it, Tony.
Go on, sorry, Tony, go on, go on.
I don't need to watch it.
There you go.
I don't need to watch it.
All right, listen, lads. All right, ladies. Liz, I have to go. Thanks very much indeed, Tony and Liz. I appreciate it. All right, now, very quickly, I've got to pick out a winner for the Salt Hill Hotel. We've got a wonderful prize to give away. We're going to send two people to the Salt Hill Hotel in Galway, just overlooking the promenade. It's Ireland's leading wedding destination. Now, we've picked a name out each day, including today. Anita McGuinness, Esther Dempsey, Siobhan O'Donnell, Jason Coogans, and Pauline Carmody. They're the names we put into the hat. And now, it's up to me to draw the winner. I have my eyes closed, I swear to God. Esther Dempsey! Yeah, Esther, you are the winner. Congratulations, Esther. You get an overnight stay for you and a friend in the Salt Hill Hotel. It's a 4-star hotel with beautiful views overlooking the Salt Hill Promenade. Congratulations. Gavin Callahan's on the way. He's going to brighten up the afternoon. I'll talk to you live again on Monday at 1 o'clock.
The PPI award-winning Niall Boylan Show. Classic hits.
Feed the whole family for €25 with a KFC O'Sanders Feast. Real mashed potato, 8 onion rings, 2 sides, a bottle of drink, and 14 pieces of 100% Irish chicken. But how about we make that chicken 200% Irish? New 200% Irish chicken from KFC. It's made by leprechauns, served in pint glasses, and feeds an extended family of 70. There's good luck in every bite.
The KFC O'Sanders Feast. 100% Irish chicken, 0% nonsense.
In participating stores until 23rd April 2017.
Students, get the edge in your exams with Limerick Tutorial College's Easter Intensive Revision Courses, April 18th to 25th. Limited offer, 5 subjects for the price of 3. That's 30 hours teaching time for only €340.